Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
When the honky-tonk man hits New York City, I hang out with the stars at the St. Regis Hotel. The best haircuts in the world. A little bit off the side, a little bit off the top this time, Sal. You can even get your shoes shined. But if you're like the honky-tonk man, you wear blue suede shoes, you don't have to worry. What some ugly-ass shoes you have on. I think I've seen those somewhere before. They look like a pair of Bruno Mars.
Yes, Times Square, the setting for the ultimate sports-themed restaurant. Yes, the official All-Star Cafe. And arriving on the scene, Sable, along with the Wild Man, Mark Merrill, ready for action tonight on Shotgun Saturday Night. Takes on the big monster Diesel.
Oh, yeah, Savio Vega takes on my former protege, Farouk.
And how about it? Rocky Maivia meets the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
And we'll be graced with a very special performance by the Honky Tonk Man.
All that and more tonight on Shotgun Saturday Night. Welcome, everyone, to Shotgun Saturday Night in the Square Circle. Big Daddy Cool Diesel out here as close as you can get.
Oh, yeah.
Vince McMahon along with the ever sexy Sonny.
Sexy Vince, you ain't seen nothing yet, baby. Wait till you see my sexy home video.
Oh, what do you have to say about it, Todd?
Somebody's gonna get lucky tonight.
Just like Mookie Wilson did when he hit that baseball through the legs of Bill Buckner to help the Mets win the 1986 World Series. However, a little bit of bad luck here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Yeah.
Earlier on today, the Sisters of Love were arrested for solicitation. It happened right there, 42nd and Broadway, Times Square, right in front of the Disney store, believe it or not.
Uh-oh.
Undercover officers arresting the sisters. They have been incarcerated, will not be in the squared circle here tonight. We'll let you know when they make bail.
Bummer. How about it? I thought they cleaned that area up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Wild Man Mark Merrill about ready to step. Uh-oh, here he comes along with Sable. Oh, yeah. Wild Man and Sable. This is someplace, I can tell you that. Cool Diesel against the Wild Man. And Sable having some degree of difficulty, as you might imagine.
Well, as all of us women do. Yeah, we do.
All right.
People get a little touchy-feely every so often walking through a crowd. It's something we have to deal with when we are overly sexy, but, you know.
Well.
Me more than the other two women in the World Wrestling Federation, though, I have to say.
I would suggest that you would think that you're the sexiest lady in all the WWE.
Oh, you know I am.
Sonny's home sex video. I can't wait to see it.
I'm the only one that has the guts to show something like that nationwide, and I'm going to do it.
Wild Man and Sable getting quite an ovation from this capacity crowd, ladies and gentlemen. A wonderful location indeed. If you ever frequent New York City, you must come to the All-Star Cafe.
You know, it's kind of sad, though. You know, I heard they had to drive here in a limousine because, you know, Mark Merrill was all upset if they had to walk the streets of New York. Sable would have gotten too many $10 offers just like that.
And look out, Wild Man being caught off guard here by this big monster Diesel. Diesel against the Wild Man, Mark Merrill.
Diesel's looking mighty fine tonight.
Indeed. Elbow striking the butt of the jaw. Too bad about those flying nuns. You wonder whether or not they'll get 3 years like Heidi Fleischer.
I don't know.
Wait a minute.
I guess here?
Diesel has eyes for Sable.
Uh-oh, this could turn into something big here.
Can you believe that? I think she just picked up. I think that's cake. Oh, and I, Right into it.
Right into the table.
Right here at the All-Star Cafe. Well, right hand.
That's what happens when somebody else hits on your woman.
And Diesel now with icing perhaps in his eyes. And look at this. Wild man Mark Merrill sets him up for the ride. A reversal. Off the rope and boom! Down the camp.
It's hard to take a big man down like that, but Mark Merrill had no problem.
Wild man Mark Merrill.
Up in the corner.
Yes, and Diesel best power his way out of this. Wild man's been all over him. Wild man taking a great exception to Diesel. And standing by right now, I believe, underneath the roundhouse. All right, here we go. In control, nice knee left there. Todd Pengill, are you standing by?
Absolutely, Vince. I'm trying to get a word here with Sable. What was Diesel saying? I mean, the cake and what was going on here with Big Daddy?
Well, Todd, let's just put it this way. I didn't like what Diesel was doing. And personally, I think he takes the cake.
Thank you very much. All right, Big Daddy Cool Diesel took the cake, all right, right in the kisser. And I think we're seeing a much more aggressive Sable than we have ever seen before. Now, whether or not some of that wears off into the Wild Man, time will tell.
Well, you know, speaking of aggressive, do you think she'd be a little upset if she saw her Honey Bunny in my home sex video?
You mean to tell me it's you and the Wild Man doing the wild thing?
Hey, you never know. I said I was doing the wild thing. You never know which Wild Man it is. Could be this one.
I must say, a great deal of speculation all week long as to just who the lucky guy is that will be seen with you later tonight.
Oh, yeah.
And again, another beautiful look at the official All-Star Cafe.
This is a great place. They even gave me a hat to wear today. What do you think?
Very nice.
I can be a hat model. Ooh, big boot.
And Diesel taking back over now on the Wild Man. By the way, Diesel's sometime tag team partner in action a little bit later on, the bad guy Razor Ramon, as we chronicled at the top of the show. It's going to be Razor against Rocky Maivia.
You know, I can't wait to see Rocky Maivia in the squared circle. I've had my eye on him lately, you know that.
Yeah, no doubt about that.
Oh, yeah.
That's who it is. It's you and Rocky.
Hey, you never know what can happen to the World Wrestling Federation. I've had my eye on Rocky for some time, and, you know, he hasn't said publicly if he likes me or not, but you know he does. Everybody does.
And right now, Diesel has his eyes on the Wild Man, and that's not all. He's just mauling him. Oh, that's what Diesel does best. Big powerhouse. What's Diesel going to do now? All right, Diesel with a little momentum and drops the elbow. That could do it.
You know, Diesel's one of the larger men in the World Wrestling Federation.
All right, one, two, and barely a kick out on the part of Wild Man Mark Merrill.
If Mark Merrill could come back and get a pinfall on Diesel, he's definitely going to progress in the World Wrestling Federation.
Wild Man back up. A lot of fighting a Wild Man.
Whoa.
However, to the outside on the apron.
Way
and Diesel again in control, right out in front of us.
It's a little too close for comfort for me.
Big Daddy Cool Diesel mauling the Wild Man, Mark Merrill. And he was outside and out there with him.
Come on, honey, do your jabs. Help him up. Oh!
Hey, wait a minute.
What?
Wait a minute. That's Razor right there.
What's going on here?
Razor.
Referee's
back his turn. All of the Wild Man and Sable taking great exception, as well she should.
Now that's something I would orchestrate.
Oh, come on.
There you go.
Razor all of the Wild Man, Mark Merrill, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have to get Razor out of here.
There's my man. Whoa.
And Rocky Maivia. Rocky Maivia. Moving Razor Ramon.
Wow.
This tag, oh my goodness, look at this. Stay with us.
Hey, NYC, New York, New York. Get ready because the World Wrestling Federation returns live to the most famous arena in the world, Madison Square Garden, Saturday afternoon, January 25th. Now, you know that Shawn doesn't like Brett. Brett doesn't like Shawn, and Psycho Sid doesn't like either one of them. And they're all going to be under the same roof in one afternoon. That spells T-R-O-U-B-L-E. 9 matches in all, 23 of your favorite WWF superstars. Psycho Sid defends the World Wrestling Federation title against the phenom of the WWF, The Undertaker. Undertaker. Shawn Michaels meets the deranged Mankind, who will have Paul Bearer in his corner. And for the first time ever in Madison Square Garden, the legendary Bret the Hitman Hart takes on the man they call Vader, off 458 pounds. You'll also see a special attraction match. Stone Cold Steve Austin meets the Bizarre Goldust. Ahmed Johnson returns to team up with Savio Vega to take on Crush and Farouk. It all happens Saturday afternoon, January 25th, and tickets, they start as low as 10 bucks.
Shotgun Saturday night, and Big Daddy Cool Diesel in black is mauling the wild man Mark Merrill.
What an incredible place this is to have such an incredible night of Shotgun Saturday night.
Earlier on, however, it was Diesel taking the cake, but not from the wild man. And then you saw him making advances towards Sable, and Sable reached over at a table very close, and then watch what she does. Oh, wow. My goodness. Back to action now. Big Daddy Cool Diesel still in control. And Wildman better be doing something.
The last time I saw a cake in the face, it was me from Ahmed Johnson, if you remember that correctly.
I do indeed. Wildman Mark Merrill and Diesel, and quite a physical match to open up things here tonight live, ladies and gentlemen, on Shotgun Saturday Night. And look at the Wildman, still a lot of fight left. And Todd Pettengill standing by with the Honky Tonk Man.
A honky tonk right here. Yeah, we're gonna hear him later on. We're gonna do a duet together. What? The Honky Tonk Man and I. That's right. Right here on Shotgun Saturday Night. I was just looking at Sable. She looks pretty good. Huh, Honky Tonk Man?
I can't believe that, Sable, but the Honky Tonk Man's got a tune especially for her. Yeah. A little love me tender.
Whoa. Back to you guys.
Woo. A little love me tender by the Honky Tonk Man. Wow.
All right, anything can happen. Here's a cover. We have a count of two in. A kick out by the Wild Man. Lawman Mark Merrill, extraordinary athlete. What an unbelievable combination of the Wild Man and Sable. But right now, the Wild Man is thinking of some measure of escape. Diesel has just been all over him. Diesel doing what he does best, big power moves and suplex down the canvas. Yet to come tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Savio Vega against Farouk. Wait a minute, here's another cover, and yet another kick out by the Wild Man, and Diesel wants a little faster count.
You may think they're an incredible combination, Vince, Mark Merrill, and Sable, but it doesn't look like she's helping him too well right now. Diesel's getting the best of him.
Honky Tonk Man to sing for us a little bit later on. He is hopeful of singing for the Grammys, which are going to appear in Madison Square Garden here in New York City.
That'll be interesting.
Later in February. Maybe a little tune-up for the Honky Tonk Man, but look at this. My goodness. Sable, who was early on quite aggressive, needs to be able to give some of that aggressiveness to the Wild Man, taking nothing away from Wild Man Mark Merrill. But that's just how big and how strong and powerful Diesel is.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I like big, strong, powerful men. You know that. But if Sable's getting a little bit aggressive lately, maybe I can give her a few classes on how to make a champion. You know, I've had three sets of tag team champions. Remember that?
Matter of fact, you have.
You know I have.
That's who it is. It's Diesel in that video we're going to see with you later tonight. Right.
Hey, you never know. I like big, tall, dark, handsome men.
And Sable.
And you know, they do call him Big Daddy Cool, so you never know.
Well, right now, Big Daddy Cool Diesel is having a problem because that pesky Wild Man Mark Merrill just won't give up. Uh-oh, and a little telegraph maneuver there for the attempted back body drop.
Mark Merrill may not be giving up, but Diesel's not going to give up either. He's going to keep it on him. One, two, three.
Diesel doing what he does best. And with a little help, I might add, a little bit earlier on, for those of you who just joined us, little help from Razor Ramon, and Rocky Maivia made sure that Razor wasn't going to be out here for too long.
Well, as far as Razor's concerned, what the referee doesn't know won't hurt him. That's what I thought for
Big Daddy Cool Diesel. What's he going to do to the outside? What's this? A new move here. Big D's going up to the top rope. On the top end. Oh!
I think it's over now.
Amazing athleticism for someone the size of this monster.
See, right now he should go for the cover.
He may have hurt himself. High risk maneuvers sometimes backfire. And Diesel may have hurt himself. Shot to the midsection, went upstairs as well, breaking the face. Diesel back in control. We're emanating, ladies and gentlemen, live from the official All-Star Cafe, Shotgun Saturday Night. Big Daddy Cool, Diesel in black. And looks like Wild Man Mark Merrill is going to be in black as well. Black and
black
blue.
Black and blue, exactly. Oh. You know, maybe Marc Mero can donate a pair of his trunks to the All-Star Cafe. You know, the loser at the All-Star Cafe to Big Daddy Cool Diesel.
And Diesel catching the wild man in midair. And if you're airborne, Vince should do it. Sable watches her man pinned. No.
Not yet.
Somehow he got his right shoulder up. And Diesel, I think, beginning to question the official.
Now, Wildman's got to reach down deep inside him from effort. Energy, and he just did that.
Tremendous desperation maneuver, nonetheless successful. That flying head scissor. And Diesel now with the Wildman sets him up underneath the roundhouse from the other side of the clothesline. And that Wildman gave it all he had there. And wait a minute, Honky Tonk Man's out here getting a close-up look of Sable. Sable attracting everyone here tonight. And the Wildman with a boot to the midsection, a clothesline. Wildman Marc Mero in control now. Wildman going, he's going upstairs. Wildman Marc Mero. And, unbelievable, Romero saw it. Oh, wait a minute. He just saw Honky Tonk.
He's just going on outside.
Honky Tonk Man out there. Oh, look out from behind. Diesel attacking Wildman Marc Mero. And it was Mero who had the upper hand until he went outside to stop Honky Tonk advancing on Sable. And look out. Here it comes. Yes.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Oh, it's got to be all over now.
And it is. And Sable.
Oh, good boy, Diesel.
Wildman Marc Mero defeated by Big Daddy Cool Diesel. Sable draws a lot of attention. There's no doubt about that.
Ooh. Oh, somebody's a little upset with his honey.
You don't think the wild man is blaming her for the loss?
Oh, I love to see a good lover's quarrel.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
little argument.
That's right, Mero. It was all her fault, honey. Come to Sonny.
Whatever she said to Sable. Goodness, stop. What's so funny about that?
Oh, poor baby. Let me get her a Kleenex. Come to Sonny, Marc.
Well, earlier today, ladies and gentlemen, we...
Oh, here we go. Honky Tonk Man will come to the rescue.
What? Honky Tonk Man?
Oh, yeah.
He is back in there. Look at that.
You do your thing, Honky Tonk.
I don't think that's Sable's idea of whom she wants to leave the dance with. Look, Honky Tonk Man out there with Sable.
He's got Sable on her knees. Don't know what he has in mind, but...
Look at the Honky Tonk Man. Look at this. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Rocky Maivia. Rocky Maivia's back out here. We saw him chase Razor Ramon away a little bit earlier on.
All right,
and Honky Tonk Man doesn't want any of that.
No, I want to know why Rocky is in the ring when I've been calling him lately.
Well, I don't know.
Maybe Rocky?
We'll ask Rocky.
Oh, come on.
Rocky assisting Sable, who is obviously distraught, not only because
the
Wild Man
lost. He's a gentleman. That's why I'm so attracted to him.
Wait a minute, here comes Wild Man back. Oh, wait a minute, a little misunderstanding here. Oh! A slugfest ensuing here. Romero and Rocky Maivia. And things are really getting out of hand, ladies and gentlemen, on Shotgun Saturday Night, I can tell you that.
Go for it, Rocky. They better get some more officials in here if they want to handle this one.
Sable is leaving with the Wild Man, I think, but in any event, oh my goodness, the Wild Man is angry. He is hot. No doubt about it.
Oh, yeah.
All right, earlier on, ladies and gentlemen, we saw the Sisters of Love. There you see them in the lineup, actually.
Did we have their mugshots?
Matter of fact, we do. The mugshots of the Sisters of Love did not have a very good day today.
Get them off the street.
They will not be here. No, they will not be here tonight. However, we will have tag team action.
They are not very
fun against the Headbangers. But right now, Sonya Vega in the square circle. And Sonya Vega is going to be meeting. Check this out. The Nation of Domination.
Here we come.
The Nation.
We are the action, loving in color. Don't diss the man, cause we'll bum rush your mother. Listen what I'm saying, it's for real, not playing. Farouk is the man, so hit your knees and start praying. The power like the bear, but quick like the cat. Two and two together, feel your face on the mat. You count the stars while the ref counts three. Hope you like to look at ceilings, cause that's all you're gonna see. He's harder than a rock, and he can't be stopped. He suck a step to the side, press you on it. The boys from the hood are on the MIC. Spitting out the lyrics, JC Ice and Wolfie D. Fans facing is the brain, crossing T's and dot I's.
This should be an extraordinary
nation
matchup.
Nation of domination. Here we are.
This is going to be, ladies and gentlemen, Savio Vega squaring off against Farouk, the leader of the Nation of Domination. In addition to which, a little bit later on, don't forget, Sonny's home sexy video.
The World Wrestling Federation is on tour, and we're bringing our unique brand of action and excitement to a town near you. Tomorrow, we invade the Thomas & Mack Center in Las Vegas. This Monday, we take over the El Paso Civic Center. From there, it's on to the Alamo Dome for the 1997 Royal Rumble. A week from Monday, we get Raw in Beaumont, Texas. Next Tuesday, we stop at the Cajun Dome in Lafayette, Louisiana. A week from Wednesday, we hit Reunion Arena in Dallas. Next Thursday, we visit Oklahoma City's Myriad Convention Center. A week from Friday, we invade the Hershey Park Arena. And in 2 weeks, we take over Madison Square Garden in New York City. Don't miss your chance to be a part of the action and excitement you can only experience live with the World Wrestling Federation.
When a terrorist threat strikes fear into the heart of America, only one man has what it takes to strike back. Jackie Chan fights for America for the first time in his biggest action movie ever. Jackie Chan's First Strike, rated PG-13, starts Friday, January 10th.
We're back, Times Square, ladies and gentlemen, the setting for the official All-Star Cafe. In the squared circle, a match already in progress. Mm-hmm. We've got Savio Vega one-on-one with the leader of the Nation of Domination, formerly managed by Sonny, in reference to Farouk.
Oh, yeah, you know, all I know is this is just cardiovascular exercise, getting ready for Ahmed Johnson, January 19th at the Royal Rumble.
Yes, indeed. It will be the Royal Rumble when Ahmed Johnson, many of you saw Ahmed in action last week, taken to the streets, so to speak, with the Nation of Domination. And Ahmed, of course, not here as we speak, but Farouk, the man he will face at the Rumble is, and Farouk and Savio having a tremendous go thus far.
Oh, yeah, but Farouk will make short work of Savio Vega. I can see he's remembered a few of my little techniques here if you pay attention to the match.
I see.
Woo! Go Farouk. There we go.
And Farouk maintaining his control.
You know, I'm glad Clarence Mason is here. You know, he's a strong proponent of Ebonics. What about you, Vince?
Well, I don't know that I necessarily agree with that.
Well,
I would suggest that I disagree with a great deal that Clarence Mason espouses. Nonetheless, Clarence Mason managing the tag team champions of the WWF. And managing this man, as well as crushing both men down to the canvas.
Now, that's not saying that Farouk, you know, practices Ebonics, so to speak. You know, he's a very well-spoken man. He's been through college. He was very successful in Florida State University.
And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, we are told, yes, you might want to get your VCRs out, because at the conclusion of this matchup, Sonny's home sex video here on Shotgun Saturday Night.
You don't want to miss this one. Pam Anderson and Jenny McCarthy move over. Maybe censored, huh?
Hey.
I hope not. I want everybody
Todd
to
Todd Pettengill standing by. Todd?
I've already got my VCR Plus all programmed. I wouldn't miss this for the world. Hey, what's your name?
My name's William.
William, where are you from?
I'm from Westchester.
All right, who do you think is going to be making love with Sonny tonight?
I don't know, but looking at her, I think it must be the $6 million man.
All right.
You know what? I wish it was me. Oh, my God.
Oh, and so do
Who's
a lot of
be?
People.
We'll find out.
He wishes it was him, and so do a lot of other people, baby. You're just going to have to wait and see.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And I think maybe we figured it out. It's Farouk, isn't it?
Well, you know, I did say we remain very close friends, but he's not really my type.
All right. So now we know who it's not.
Savio Vega with Farouk off his feet, and you can't mount an offense when you're up like that. Just a question of where you're going to go down. Savio Vega now able to mount an offense. Savio Vega drops big Farouk down on his neck, and Vega crawling over for a cover. And now Vega, I guess that took almost as much out of Savio as it did Farouk.
Come on, Farouk, you still got some wind in you, baby.
Farouk with a whole lot of support out here, notwithstanding your presence. Of course, he has his a whole nation of domination. Woo! A cover, a count, and, and somebody woke Farouk up just in the nick of time.
Everybody's here. We got Clarence Mason, D'Lo, Shadeem, Wolfie, and JC Ice all in support of Farouk, as well as myself.
Back there on their feet now, both men, Savio Vega and Farouk. And Vega, what a nice back body drop. Savio Vega trying to set up Farouk now and snaps him back. Crushing leg sweep, nicely done. Savio Vega going for a cover. We have to hook the leg in. A little leverage there, but not enough to put Vic Farouk down, who is really one of the stronger individuals here in the WWF.
Oh, yeah.
And without a doubt, one of the tougher individuals as well.
Oh, absolutely. Why do you think I brought him to the World Wrestling Federation?
Smack of the flesh. Savio Vega chopping away and now hammering away on Farouk. Off the rope. Yes, putting heel kick nicely done into the rib area. Savio Vega looking to pull off what would be somewhat of an upset considering the entire nation of domination is out here. One, we have, oh, come on, get him down. That was a Wolfie D. Distracting the official, JC Ice. Come on. And that's what happens when you have so many individuals out here. It's tough for the official to maintain some control. And now the match turning back around in Farouk's favor. As if Farouk couldn't do it on his own. Farouk now.
There we go.
Suplex nicely done.
There's a feat of strength by Farouk. You know, Savio Vega's a large man also, but being a little bit on the smaller side than Farouk, he may have a little bit more cardiovascular time going.
This big monster, Farouk, continuing to just kick away at Savio Vega. And Vega must mount an offense. In the event you just joined us, ladies and gentlemen, Savio Vega and Farouk going at it, one-on-one, single competition live tonight from the official All-Star Cafe. This is Shotgun Saturday Night. And at the conclusion of this matchup, we're going to see for the first time anywhere, live here on Shotgun, Sonny's home sex video.
You know, you keep talking about it, Vince. It seems like you're supposed to be the one to say it.
Well, I can tell you, but everybody's been talking about that all week long.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to outdo Marlena from last week.
And I can do that very easily.
Oh, really? We're going to find out. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, good look at the official All-Star Cafe. We are live in the proximity of Times Square. And Savio Vega now mounting an offense. Here we go. Oh, nobody there.
All right. There we go. Tango.
By Buster, nicely executed by
Farouk.
Cover. Is that an offense?
Oh.
It is.
There we go.
There he is. Farouk, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yeah.
The leader. The nation of domination, victorious.
And you need to put one hand in the air and salute.
All right. There he is. Victorious, ladies and gentlemen.
For the man.
And Ahmed is next. Farouk against Ahmed at the Royal Rumble. Who knows what's going
to
happen? All right, ladies and gentlemen, pick up the phone and call somebody, as the expression goes. Yes, because,
what's next, baby?
You know what's next. Everyone awaiting for this.
Sonny's
home sex video.
Oh, you know it is. You want to show them?
Well,
put the kids away. Trust me, this is too hot and heavy for them. Woo, I'm going to get some phone calls after this one.
Let's take a look.
Everybody's going to be begging.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to my lair of love. As you can see here, I have my favorite Christmas present of all, Tickle Me Elmo. Now everybody knows that's the hottest Christmas present this season. So of course the hottest woman in the World Wrestling Federation just had to have one. But you're probably all wondering who that special man in my life is. Who's the man that I make love to each and every night? Is he tall, dark, and handsome? Or maybe blonde and muscular? Well, you're about to meet him. Come on in, baby. There you go. Come to mama. Woo! Dance for me, honey. There you go. What a body. What a body. Come here.
Come on. Bother me, Elmo!
That's right. It's not Tickle Me, Elmo.
No!
It's his big, strong,
very big,
bad,
very bad,
older brother, Fondle Me, Elmo!
Oh!
Oh, yeah!
Take me, Sonny!
Come here.
Oh! Wow!
Are you ready for me, baby?
Wow!
Mm-hmm.
The night the
get
the
ready to
night.
Ride Space Mountain. Okay, don't worry about that. The Energizer Bunny's got nothing on you.
I need a cigarette. Mm.
You're a madman.
Oh, I know, that's right. Sonny?
Yeah?
Where's Fond of Me Elmo's pants?
I don't know, babe.
Sonny?
What?
Where's Fond of Me Elmo's?
Things are heating up a little bit out here.
Hey, yeah.
They are speechless, big man. What do you think about that?
Unbelievable, Todd Pettengill. Things warming up over there where you are, too, I guess.
Uh-huh. We're getting ready. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Honky Tonk Man, we're going to do a duet. It's going to be great. Uh-huh. I'm going to wiggle my leg. I'm going to swivel my hips. Yeah, I got it. Hey, runners, everybody. We'll be back.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed. The All-Star Cafe, the setting for tonight's Shotgun Saturday Night. And here we go. Todd Pettengill and the Honky Tonk.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, the Honky Tonk Man is ready to sing. Let's do it.
The girls call him Honey. The guys call him King. He can wrestle, play guitar, plus dance and sing. Now he's back, looking for just one thing. A new champion to wear a jumpsuit in the ring.
Come on, Hulk!
Beat my opponent, 1, 2, 3. The best intercontinental champ was me.
Yeah!
I kick him in the butt all over the place. Never in a champ with such a pretty face. So watch out.
Yeah!
I'll get this place.
Woo-hoo.
I'm a Hulk Hogan man. Let him know the ring.
Come on, man, sing with us. With his sideburns and his old guitar,
there's never ever been a cooler superstar. He'd drop you on your head or kick you in the chest and never put a wrinkle in his rhinestone vest. Now he's back,
looking for just one thing, yeah!
A new superstar to wear a jumpsuit in the ring.
Let's sing about it.
A honk, honk, honky tonk man, baby. Honk, honk, honky tonk man, baby. A honk, honk, honky tonk man.
Shotgun Saturday night, so watch out.
I'll be in this place.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
I'm a honky tonk man, a legend of the ring.
Big finish now, here we go.
A honky tonk, honky tonk man, baby. A honky tonk, honky tonk man, baby. A honk, honk, honky tonk man, baby. A honk, 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 a honky tonk. He's the honky tonk man, a legend of the ring.
Honky's headed to the Grammys, but maybe the Slammies.
You know, after seeing
Honky Tonk Man!
After seeing this and hearing him sing, I'm leaning
Brandon Wartrich did as well. They did have the number one grossing concert tour this year.
All right, and Rocky Maivia. And look at Honky. Honky getting an exception. The Rocky Maivia. Likely to steal the spotlight from anyone. And I will assure you that Rocky can wrestle a little bit better than the Honky Tonk Man can sing.
Well, I have to say so.
What a reception for Rocky Maivia. The first ever three-generation WWF superstar. His grandfather, the High Chief Maivia. His dad. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Razor Ramon attacking Rocky Maivia.
Oh, that's just not fair. It was even before the bell.
Off the rope.
All right, there we go, Rocky.
And Rocky, oh, nice drop kick. Mm-hmm. His dad, Rocky Johnson, taught him how to drop kick just like that.
Oh, yeah. One of the best drop kicks in wrestling.
Rocky Maivia, standing side headlock. Of course, Rocky Johnson looking on, ladies and gentlemen, live. And Tampa Florida catching the elbow. Rocky Johnson, former WWF Tag Team Champion. He is hopeful his son likewise will be a champion. And Razor Ramon now from the other side. From Coho, nicely executed. Quickly back to his feet. What a sensational athlete Rocky Maivia is.
I think Rocky's going to win and reel him in hook, line, and sinker like I did to all of you in my home sex video.
I must say that that was most unusual.
Oh, unusual. It's the hottest thing you'll ever see, baby.
And what is Honky Tonk Man doing out here now?
What is he doing
here?
Oh,
my goodness. Whatever it is, he's up to no good. No doubt about that, ladies and gentlemen. Honky Tonk Man's out there to shake, rattle, and roll. Stay with us. Action will continue. We're live, the Ultimate Sports Theme Restaurant, the official All-Star Cafe. And Razor Ramon and Rocky Maivia, oh my goodness, having a go in single competition. And Razor has been battering Rocky Maivia.
Well, you know, Razor's experience in the ring is definitely overpowering the naiveness, I guess you'd say, of Rocky Maivia, because he's got the upper hand.
And Rocky has been distracted repeatedly through the break by the Honky Tonk Man, who's been out at ringside, and again, as we said before, has really no reason to be out there. Other than to cause trouble. Razor now tries to set up the youngster. He's a rookie. Rocky Maivia from the other
there
side.
Ronnie
Crescent gets a big man
he
down.
He may be a rookie, but he's
almost
good.
Enough to put him away. Oh, and a clothesline. And Razor now, after that clothesline, trying to capitalize on Rocky Maivia. Maivia to the buckle. Razor, all over it. Razor Ramon, we've seen him repeatedly throughout the night. Firstly, interfering in Diesel's matchup. And you wonder whether or not Diesel might interfere in this matchup,
oh,
although the Honky Tonk Man out about ringside as we speak. And a look of concern on Sonny's face.
Rocky,
obviously
come on, baby.
Are somewhat infatuated with Rocky Maivia.
Well, you know, why wouldn't I be? Look at him. If you were a woman, you'd be. Or maybe you are anyway.
No thanks.
You like that. You never know.
Rocky trying to get back to his feet. Right into the midsection and another one.
Oh, come on, Rocky. Get it together, baby.
Honky Tonk Man looking on. And Razor. Planting that knee right in the back of the neck, right in the back of the head, if you would, and rearing way back on the chin.
Oh, come on, Rocky, don't give up, baby. Fire up.
And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, we're told that Todd Pettengill is making his way as we speak out to Times Square. But we are live. The All-Star Cafe, Shotgun Saturday Night, a most unusual setting as it is each and every week for a most unusual event, Shotgun Saturday Night.
That's one word for it.
Next week, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, we will be in San Antonio, Texas, live.
Oh, that's just humiliation there.
For Shotgun Saturday Night, and a yank of the hair there by Razor Ramon. And Razor doing everything to keep Rocky down on a canvas. Rocky nonetheless back up on his feet now. Off the rope and a knee squarely into the abdominal area. And Razor now with a clothesline to the back of the head and hurling through this. Oh, come on.
Come on. He's got to stick his nose in everybody's business.
And those aren't blue suede shoes Honky Tonk Man has on right now. They're boots. And on the receiving end of those boots, Rocky Maivia. And that Razor must be the man that Rocky's looking for. Oh, no. Here we go. Razor says no. Back.
Yeah, there we go.
And a rake in the face, and again, right back in. No, look at this. Here we go. Rocky spinning Razor around. What's he going to do with him? Gets him up. Uh-oh, how about that?
Oh, yeah.
Shoulder breaker.
There we go, Rocky. It's over.
That's it. We got it. Rocky got him.
There we go. There's my boy. Raise his hand right there.
And Honky Tonk Man was looking at Razor Ramon. I don't think he's going to be looking any better for this match. The official All-Star Cafe, the setting for Shotgun Saturday night. We're having a blast inside, outside, out in Times Square, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Todd Pettengill somewhere out there doing something.
Todd,
can you hear us? Todd Pettengill, are you there?
Thank you very much, Vince. I feel like Dick Clark out here in the middle of Times Square, only there's no visible ball dropping. It is cold, and you know what? One of the hottest things in the New York City area is real estate. People can't find it, so they make it. You ever been inside one of these babies? Unbelievable. They got cable TV. They got jacuzzis. Hot and cold running everything. You can see that's where the heat comes from. So it's a bonus. You have no heat bill. Now let me give you a little tour around because over here, the guest quarters.
Your
mother-in-law comes in, she stays right here. You don't want her in a main house. These things are absolute. If I could peel this back.
Як ти говориш того? Я то спавам ту.
Oh my goodness.
You understand English?
Я
спавам ту.
Я говорю
фулка. I live here because that's all I get.
Unbelievable. Back, wow. Ladies and gentlemen, and ready for action. Yes. We have Doug Furness and Philip LaFon ready for tag team action. However, before we go to tag team action, how about next weekend? Next week, you have to be talking about Goldust. I mean, we saw Goldust last week looking pretty good, although Marlena looked better.
Well, you know, Goldust wasn't showing, so to speak, but Marlena certainly was.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, she was. But speaking of showing, ladies and gentlemen, it's official. Goldust is pregnant.
Yes. Check that out.
There you see it. On the cover of a well-known magazine, Goldust, ladies and gentlemen, pregnant, and he will give birth live here on Shotgun Saturday night. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, the Lenox Hill Hospital here in New York City will be the setting for the live birthing of a Goldust baby. Will it be a boy or will it be a girl?
I don't know, maybe both, but you know, no one's seen Madonna's baby yet, but we're going to see Goldust and not on the Rosie O'Donnell Show, baby, exclusively here on Shotgun.
Anything can happen, ladies and gentlemen, here on Shotgun Saturday night. We'll be right back with tag team actions. Stay with us. We're back, ladies and gentlemen. Shotgun Saturday night. Tag team action already ensuing in the squared circle. We've got Dirk Furness and Philip LaFon against the Headbangers. And yes, everyone having a grand old time thus far tonight, live from the official All-Star Cafe in the squared circle right now. Let me see, that's Mosh of the Headbangers.
With Phil LaFon.
Oh, against Phil LaFon.
You know, Phil LaFon and Doug Furness are definitely a tag team to reckon with now here in the World Wrestling Federation. Because they were five-time All-Asian tag champs for All Japan Pro Wrestling in Japan. Do you know that?
Well,
I can say
is that everyone here is having, well, not almost as good a time as Fondo Me Elmo had earlier on, but not quite. We're having a grand old time here. But, not quite as much as Elmo's. He was bigger, stronger, furrier, whatever he was.
Yeah, Fondo Me Elmo is definitely a handy.
Oh,
but,
wow,
you know, I want to do some research on this Doug Furness. He's got a pretty good looking body, too.
Doug Furness and Philip LaFon undefeated thus far here in the World Wrestling Federation, and the Headbangers taking the place of the Sisters of Love, who were arrested, as we saw earlier, for solicitation. Can you imagine that? Out on 42nd Street. I thought they cleaned that area up.
Oh, here we go. Tagging the power of the team in. Doug Furness has held various powerlifting championships in his long career. And he's definitely a force to reckon with. And these Headbangers are going to feel his force pretty well.
Little double team effort there from Furness and LaFon. It's Doug Furness in there against Mosh of the Headbangers. Mosh and Thrasher of the Headbangers. That's Thrasher coming in now. And Thrasher, let's see what he's going to do now. Double team effort as well. Dirk Furness catching the flying clothesline and down to the canvas.
Into a pinning combination, and that is
not quite enough to put Dirk Furness away. Mosh moving in. Succession of blows to the midsection. A boot followed by a right hand. Mosh and Thrash. A most unusual tag team combination, to say the least. And Furness and LaFon better get it together here, ladies and gentlemen, live. This matchup continuing. Stay with us for more Shotgun.
We are live in Times Square. Check this guy out. He's got a Michael Jackson mask on. Of course, this week we're in Times Square, but next week we will be coming to you live from San Antonio, Texas. Oh, it's going to be great. Now, Venom and Diamond, everybody who's anybody in the World Wrestling Federation is going to be there. We're going to be line dancing. We're going to be jamming. The action is going to be huge. Plus, remember, Goldust will give birth back here in New York. That's next week on Shotgun. Back to you guys at ringside.
Yeah. We'll be doing some line dancing and square dancing next week, won't we, Vinny Mac?
I suppose so. Woo! Diamond's the setting. Nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, tag team action has been hot and furious all before the break.
There we go.
Dirk Furness, Philip LaFon against the Headbangers. Thrasher and Mosh and ho! Look here, ladies and gentlemen. And there we go. It happened. Okay. One, two, and that's enough. Oh, come on. And unfortunately, it looks like we might be running over time, ladies and gentlemen. We will show you the ending of this matchup next week when we see you live from San Antonio, Texas. So long.
See ya.
Shotgun Saturday night.